And hello and welcome to tonight's coverage of Davidson Varsity Soccer here on DTV. I am Randall W. Scott III.
And I am Michael David Brizio.
All right, and we got a good matchup today between the Cardinals and the Saginaw Heritage team traveling down from Saginaw today. We got a beautiful day outside. What do we know about these two teams?
Well, they're very evenly matched. They've both been going pretty good this season. Davidson has a 9-3-3 record. And Saginaw Valley has a 6... Sorry, not... What were they again?
Heritage. Saginaw Heritage.
Saginaw Heritage have a 6-7-3 record.
Mm-hmm. So we got teams both with winning records here. Well, Saginaw's got a losing record, but they come from the Saginaw Valley Conference. And if you're not familiar with that conference, the Flint schools are in that conference. Flint Central, Flint Northwestern, Flint Northern, as long as the Bay City and the Saginaw schools. Some of the Saginaw schools, Arthur Hill and Saginaw Heritage and Saginaw High, are all in that conference.
This is the first time they're going to be meeting this season, but they did play last year.
Do we know what the result of last year's game was?
Well, the Saginaw coach said they won, but he wasn't entirely confident about that.
Oh, hey, we're in the action already. I got hit with the ball, and we're only a few seconds in. All right, one key note to know for Davidson, Sam Weber, one of the forwards, is out. He's one of the key offensive players for this team, and he's out due to an injury today, so we'll be playing without Weber. Game's on the way.
Build that up in the middle there, Brandon.
You can hear Coach Appleby behind us screaming for his team to work it in the middle. And that is number 9, Ben Marengo out there.
Tried working it down the wing there, but Saginaw got the ball back again now.
He's got a full head of steam here. That's number 11 for Saginaw.
Full of energy.
Yes. That's Derek Rupp. We have to watch out for him. We can see he's a speed burner. And here comes a chance, but the Saginaw keeper's right on task in front of it.
Oh, they let that one slip now.
Both teams very energetic off the bat here. A lot of energy.
Yeah, good passing there by Saginaw. And that'll be a goalie's ball. No, a corner.
Oh, they're going to call that a corner kick? So Saginaw with a chance to strike early here on the corner kick. I can't see. That's kind of out there. I think that's number 19 getting ready to take that kick. Charles Warner. So he's going to tee it up. We'll see if he goes right to the net with it or kicks it short. And he kicks it
low ball.
Short. Yep.
Never looked like scoring there. And over the crossbar.
Onto the tennis courts. Put a little extra on that. So we're going to tee it up from the corner again. They said it bounced off the Davidson player. All right, let's see if they try the same thing. I think they'll go with a different one here.
Higher ball this time. No one to get the header, though.
Got a little pushing and shoving there. Davidson defense.
Another cross in, but no one on the end of it. And now there's a chance for Davidson, but it's cleared.
And our second ball of the day. I'm on fire. That's number 14, Mulholland.
Another throw-in.
Lots of Mulholland boys on the soccer team. One of them graduated last year, Josh. We kind of lose the ball in that far corner there, so. It's Luke LeBlanc. They got two different numbers here. They have a home number and a away number, so. Oh, that's their line number. So 11 would be Lucas LeBlanc. That's the guy with the curly hair up the middle. The very energetic one today. Got another corner kick. It's a third corner kick already. Wind is blowing to the east pretty hard. So it's blowing towards the Davidson goal.
Low ball in, but no one to get on the end of it, and it's cleared down by Davidson.
Here comes the Cooley.
Oh, good passing there.
Mm,
taking it straight down the line.
Dangerous play there. Yeah, that's going to be a kick. High kick there. So Dave's going to have a chance to push up. Looks like McManaman's going to take it. Comes McManaman, the senior. Had some serious hook on that one.
Still in it, though.
It looks like we'll have a Saginaw throw. So we're about 5 minutes in now. Still no serious shots, no serious threats. Mike, I understand you are from Australia. Is that what I'm understanding?
Yep, from Melbourne.
Melbourne?
Yep.
And you are an exchange student this year here at Davison?
Yeah, I'm here for just the semester. So.
All right. Mike's helping us out today. Who's your host family?
I'm living with the Embry family.
All right.
So big hello to them.
And how is your stay in America been so far?
So far it's been excellent. Really enjoying going to school and getting involved, I guess.
All right. Soccer's a big deal in Australia, right?
Yeah, in recent years in particular, because last year we just broke our World Cup drought. And we 32 years since we last won in it. So bit of interest lately.
Fair enough. Fair enough. Now, what's bigger out there? Is it rugby or is it soccer?
Well, I suppose it depends which state you're in, because the northern states are really into rugby. And but no matter where you are, I think soccer's probably the second most popular sport.
So we're treating you well here in Davison so far?
Yeah.
All right. Is this your first TV work?
Yeah. Well, in broadcasting, yeah. I've had a bit of experience with short films and just general stuff like that, yeah.
All right. Well, I'm sure they're going to love to hear your voice all day, so I'll try to keep it down like you do most of the talking.
Yeah.
Oh, caught one in the face there. That's Snyder. A big battle. Saved there by the Heritage goalie. Heritage goalie, we're going with the all gray today. Usually the goalies go for the colorful look.
Straight back to Davison with the kick.
That's 19.
Oh, forced. Yeah, went straight one out. Straight out. Poor control there. He could lose the ball. Yep, he has.
Good physical play there. That's LeBlanc again. He's going to be a pest all day. He's all over the field. Nice move.
Oh, strong defense there. I want to kick it to though, and they'll get it straight back. Heritage. Oh, some fancy skills along the wing there.
Yeah, showing off the footwork.
Centering ball, there a chance, but straight back to the keeper there.
And that's Cousineau. You guys might recognize that name. He was a wide receiver on the football team last year. And now he switched over. He's playing some goalie for the Cardinals. He's in an imposing presence back there. He's a big guy.
Forced over the line there.
The other way.
Throwing. Took it straight away.
Heritage really pushing the action so far here today.
Yep.
And there they go again. So I have another throw Heritage way. Yeah, definitely I think Heritage is pushing the action more today, and Davison's kind of on the defensive early on. Of course, there's a lot of game left, but they've had three corner kicks so far. But
yeah, I spoke to their coach before the game, and he said the game plan was to pepper the goalie with as many shots as they can, and so far I think that's what they're really doing.
Yeah, that pepper is a good word for what they're doing so far. They haven't really got any really good tough shots, but they're peppering them with shots. That's what they're doing. And that's kind of how you got to do it. You know, you get there, hope for a rebound or for one to sneak in. Just constantly stay around the goal area.
Heritage take the safe option with that one and kick it out.
Mm-hmm. Got an extremely warm day. It was about 80 degrees today. 80 degrees in October in Michigan. It's rare that we get to enjoy one of these. We tried to come out for the Grand Blanc game last Monday, but the elements kept us away. Davidson lost that game 1-0.
Probably a good thing then.
Yeah. But they played tough. It was a tough game. Grand Blanc scored early, a few minutes into the first half, and that was the only scoring for the rest of the game. Played out the midfield. Once again, Saginaw controls. Nice play. Nitzke's having a good game out there on that wing. He's made a couple good plays here. Mulholland.
Yeah.
Mulholland battling out there.
Opening up now for Davison. Again, taking the safe heritage.
That was a nice little play there by Mulholland and then McDowell. In the corner there. All right, that's going to be a goal kick.
Substitution for the Hawks, number 3, Alvin Byers.
All right, Byers checks in for Saginaw. First substitution of the game for either team. Not a big leg there. So with the chance here.
Cleared by Heritage and so nearly. Davison get it back though.
It's one of the captains, Marengo. Good play by McManaman, man, to get it out. Good job. We got a good crowd out there too today. Both bleachers pretty full.
Yeah.
Saginaw brought a big contingent, and of course Davison always got a good crowd out here for the soccer games. Got a good DTV crew too. I'm surrounded by Zach Hall, the executive producer, and Greg Pulaski, the sports director. And we got Jeff Hollis, man in the camera today. He's doing a fine job. And of course, Stacy, the trainer, always here. Just got to tape up my ankle at halftime. This announcing's a tough sport. Heritage tries to cross it, but going nowhere. Nice play.
Oh, they need to clear it now.
And clear it they do. Davison with the chance coming the other way. Ooh, offsides. Nope. Look, Saginaw, they were offsides definitely there.
Lucky there.
Yeah. Saginaw maintained control, so they didn't blow the whistle. Yeah, the Saginaw defense is definitely pulling up on us and trying to catch us offsides every time. Playing up really high on us. And Cousineau will play that one. 27-18 left now in the first half. No score. Saginaw Heritage, Davison Cardinals. Just underway here. Both teams kind of feeling each other out. Saginaw, I would say, had the upper hand early, but... But it's not a distinct advantage. Both teams still kind of.
Both sides have been pushing forward a lot, but both sides have very good defenses.
Yep. Oh, that was probably the best chance of the game for Heritage.
Just wide there.
Yep. It was a very good look, and I think that's number 11 again. That's LeBlanc. He knows it too. He put his shirt up over his head. He knew he missed a good opportunity there.
Substitution for Saginaw Heritage, number 8, EJ Evans.
And number 8, Evans just checked in for Heritage. Looks like McManaman's going to take the goal kick. Instead of Cousineau, McManaman's got a big foot. We know that. That's against the wind right there. He got it over midfield. All right, there you go. Got it now.
This is a good chance.
Yeah. Yeah, that defense is doing a good job pulling up on us, and they caught McDowell offsides. He was a good 10 feet offsides, I think. Mm-hmm. That would have been a great opportunity. Good communication there, though.
Yep.
Scared me for a minute, but Cousineau took charge.
Hard ball from McDowell. Mm-hmm. Can't keep it in there.
Going to be a Saginaw throw. Into LeBlanc, good head. Those Heritage defenders are pretty big. Oh, got a handball on that one. I don't know about that call, but we'll go with it. There's McManaman. You can always tell when McManaman kicks it goes a long way.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Two on
oh,
one.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, offsides again. Got him again. Wow. Yeah, caught him again. That would have been another great opportunity for McDowell, but he's getting a little excited and getting there before
yep.
the ball.
Mm-hmm.
Offsides in soccer is when they when there is before the ball gets there, you have to be behind the defenders. So you can't be between the goal and the defenders if you're an offensive player. There has to be a defensive player behind you or the ball in between you and the goal. Nice left footer. Played well by Davison. It's Mulholland and LeBlanc there. Mulholland gets it. Sends it up. He's onside this time.
One on one now. Can he get past him?
Nice pass. Good try. Ugh. Gotta go attack.
Again with the safe option.
Oh, they're going to call that a Saginaw throw. They're going to say it bounced off of McDowell, is what they're going to say. I thought it went right between his legs. Goes McManaman again.
Got another high long ball there.
Got under that one a little bit. Here we go. Oh, yeah, it's going to be a kick the other way. Too much body on that one by Crawford. I'm sorry, that was Noble. Noble on that one. A little too much body.
Had a good chance to header it to McDowell, though. Would have been a good setup there.
Mm-hmm. Here we go the other way. Another chance.
Nobody there, though.
Again. Would have been offsides again. Well, Saginaw controls. They got to make some adjustments there on the offsides call. They're doing a good job trapping them. This throw is going to go Saginaw's way also. So Davison really yet to get a good shot on goal. And we are at 22 and a half minutes left in the first half.
In the game for the Hawks, number 16, Matthew Lopez.
And Saginaw making another change. So we had the delay here. Big throw. Not bad. That's LeBlanc. Davison wins the ball. Look inside, good passing. Here comes Mulholland. Mulholland sends him. We're onside this time, but it was a little too far. That's Burke with a big header.
Into some space, but Heritage to get it back now.
And McManaman,
yep.
Big play. Ran up on him from about 20 yards back. Oof. Oh, little collision there. Way to bring it back. Good cross. It looks like Davison will get to it first. That's the way you got to do that, though. You got to totally cross the field and change directions there if you're in offense. Oh,
ooh, brought down there.
Kick, yeah. Got the best of Snyder there. Knocked him right off his feet. again with 21 minutes left now in the first half. No score, Davison Saginaw Heritage. See if he can get the cross here. And he does, he crossed it right in front. Played. Oh,
no one with the shot on goal though.
Oh, that was brilliantly done though. That was nice work. I think that was Mulholland in the corner with the cross. Was that Mulholland?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was Mulholland. Oh, that's a little physical play. No call there.
Oh, that's controversial.
And a shot on goal. Good save by Cousineau.
You read it well.
Wow, a lot of body on that though. That was player from Heritage really stuck it to us. But no call, and he got a great shot on net. Kuzno was playing him in the right spot, made a good diving stop. And here we go, we're waiting on a Saginaw throw here. Tying his shoe. And here it comes. Nyski doing a good job there, locking that player up. Nyski's played a fine job back there on defense. So we got another substitution, and number three, Byers, will take the throw for Heritage. Big throw. Heritage plays it back. Nice play. Crosses it across.
Centering ball to the other team.
Call there. Saginaw player holding his ankle, and they'll stop play for him. Looks like he just got a little stuffed up. He should be okay. And that's Lopez for Heritage, and he'll stay in the game. Yeah, he just collided there with one of the Davison players. He'll be fine. They're going to give Saginaw a kick on this, which is surprising. And that's an indirect kick. So he'll tee it up, and it goes just over. And Davison will get the goal kick. 18 minutes now left, first half. 0-0 score. Davison and Saginaw Heritage. Davison has one game left before the districts. On the 11th, they will play Swartz Creek Dragons, and that'll wind up the regular season for them. And if you remember last year, Davison made a run in the districts. They won the district championship, beating Grand Blanc and then Carmen after that. A couple surprise wins, and won the district championship, but lost in the first round of the regionals.
Into some space now.
This is the Cooley right up the middle, and there's got to be a call on that. What are we going to get? Oh, and it's going to be a kick. They're going to call the Cooley for pushing.
Giving a lot of space there, Heritage.
Go one more chance for Davison. Offsides, that's a bad call, I think, on that one. Oh, I think the ball was in front there. I think play that out, but they call Crawford getting ahead there. So that's the fourth time now we've had good breaks called offsides. That one I'm not so sure of, though.
Head out straight to the defense of the other team.
When man gets under it, it goes a mile high.
All over the place at the moment.
Crawford, one of the captains on this team, plays it back to McManaman. Plays a little. Here comes Crawford again. Crawford's been kind of quiet today, but here he comes now. He sends it up, and offsides again. Yeah, that was offsides. Yeah, that one was definitely offsides. Not by much, but he was definitely off. They're really, really, really trapping us on that.
Yep.
And then offsides. All right, here comes some subs now for Heritage. Mike, how would you say this first half has went for both teams? Give us a little breakdown.
Well, Heritage have been given the more opportunities, whereas Davison have tried to create the opportunities but have been caught off by the offsides too many times.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think now they've squandered about four good scoring opportunities with offsides calls, and Heritage hasn't had but one really good shot, I would say. Maybe two. One went a little wide. And Kuzno made one really great save. But other than that, there's a reason why we're stuck at zero, because there hasn't been it's been pretty evenly played.
Mm-hmm. We got another corner kick now for Heritage.
They had three really early in this half. Couldn't capitalize on any of them. Davison made played some pretty good defense on them. So they've kicked a couple short and a couple long. Let's see what they do with this one. Short again.
Davison regain.
Here comes the Cooley now. And we'll have a kick Davison's way, or a throw Davison's way.
Coming forward now for Heritage, looking for a good pass, but it's cleared there by the defense of Davison.
Cool.
Goalkeeper coming out, a risky move.
Yeah, he was way out there. No need to come way that far out. Here comes Crawford now. Crawford is Davison's leading scorer. He's got 9 goals on the year. So I'd like to see him get in a little bit more of the action here. All right, good ball handling. Keeping it away from Saginaw. There's the good move. Cross it across. Kuzno plays it.
Heritage now with the throw in. Another substitution holding us back.
Substitutions for Saginaw, number 11, Lucas LeBlanc, and number 4, Curtis McGillivray. Subs for Davison, number 1, Trevor McDowell, and number 11, Zach Johnson.
Here we go, here comes McDowell playing the other wing now. Gets a shot on goal, but
straight down the throat of the goalie.
Oh, played the ball there, but definitely got the body, so Davison will have a kick. Looks like Casey Smith will see his first action of the day. Also, number 20, Trainer, comes in. Casey Smith, a DTV student, one of my own. And sitting down will be Snyder and Crawford. They'll take a little break here before the half. Like I said, Crawford is Davison's leading scorer on the year.
So a free kick now. It's going to force the defense back a little more. Hopefully create an opportunity for Davison now.
Goes McManaman. Plays it right in front of the goal.
High one.
Nice.
Looking
play
for a header. No one can get on it, though.
It's a way to do it. That's probably their best look of the game so far, I would say. Had a good chance there.
Another high ball, but No one there.
Here comes.
Oh, opportunity.
Oh, goalie comes out. Here comes McDowell. Davis is still controls down there. Let's see if he can get a shot off.
It's high, but the goalie will get that one.
Mm-hmm. Nice play there by the keeper for Saginaw. Yeah, Saginaw thought they cleared that one, but kicked it off their own defender, and Davidson had one more opportunity. Oh, a lot of speed there for Heritage. Speed us right to the ball. Mahalan will throw quickly. He's going to move. 10 minutes now left, first half. And he sends it back for the keep. Here we go with McDowell again. Oh, it's a call here. I don't know what the call was there. Is that another offsides?
Came a bit late, I think, but perhaps that's what it was.
I think that's what it was. Oh, an elbowing call? Okay. A little rough play on the Davidson part.
Again, Heritage getting a lot of space down there in the middle.
Smith's going good playing the ball.
He's got two open men to choose to there. Takes it himself. Goes wide again.
He did the no-look pass there. Uh-oh, that could be an
opportunity here.
McManaman, way to come back. Oh, they're going to call a push on him, so this is going to be a kick here. And he's going to get a yellow card. Kicked it away afterwards. McManaman will get a yellow card for that. Kind of upset with himself and didn't like the call as well. So he'll have to sit down. And that might be a defensive breakdown, we'll say. Coach warned against having defensive breakdowns for the day. Let's see if he just got a yellow or did he get a red.
I didn't see it that way, Coach. That's what I said. Coach, gentlemanly conduct, is that what that?
Get four in here, Trevor.
9-11.
Trevor, get four in here.
There's now 9 minutes, 11 seconds left. This will be a direct kick here from Saginaw. Looks like number 11. Is that who's taking that kick? No, it's number 16. He sends it short.
Low ball.
Boy, I don't know why they don't kick that towards the net. All right. Well, Holland, good play. And it's going to be a Davidson throw.
Moving taken quickly.
Ooh. McDowell with the header. That's going to be a kick our way. Heritage player shaking up on that. And looks like another ankle problem. Trainer Stacy's over there to work with him. All right, Crawford's back in, and he'll take the kick.
Substitution for the Hawks, number 18, Justin Zerwicki.
Boot comes flying off there.
Somebody didn't have him laced up tight enough. All right, and there's LeBlanc now. He's got the rock. Nice ball, good play.
Busted there.
Here comes Smith now. He's got time. Eight thirty now left in the first. Oh, here's a play. Kuzno comes out, cuts it off nicely. Appleby doesn't stop. Boy, he's calling out orders all day long. I even heard the Heritage coach once. But you can hear Appleby every second. He's letting the players know where they should be and what they should be doing. All right, wind's starting to pick up here now. You can start to hear it.
Yep.
So, and it is blowing towards the Davidson goal in this half. So. Now left in the half. No score. Davidson, Saginaw Heritage. First half action. That's Super Fad. Randy Braden in the house today at every soccer game. Every time I come to a soccer game, every time I come to every game, he's there. Nice to see him out.
Heritage now again in a lot of space going forward.
Here comes Byers. This Byers kid can really fly. He's fast.
High clearance there.
Here comes Smith. Gives it the left foot. Byers controls now for Heritage. Holland's going to take the throw. Nope, he's going to give it up, and that's going to be Knightsky's throw.
We got a wave of substitutions here.
Yeah, half the team's coming on and off. We're not even going to try to keep up with all those. I see McDowell sitting down. I see Zach Johnson sitting down. And also Trainer comes back out. DeCooley's back in. There's Byers, a couple head balls in a row. Sets it forward. Here comes the Cooley. Got to watch that offsides again. It was close again. This is LeBlanc for Heritage. Up the side.
Good work there, two against one.
Here comes the Cooley. Stops and controls. He's on Byers. Much bigger than Byers. Let's see if he tries to use that to his advantage.
Looks for a centering pass.
Got a center. All right, there it is. Too far. Coming in from the wing. Oh. Who was that running in from the wing?
Another shot. No.
Ooh. That was almost a
own goal.
Yeah. Scoring on themselves, Heritage almost did. That was a good run there by Schneider. He came up out of nowhere and almost had a chance to take that DeCooley centering play and put it in the net, but he just missed it. So we're going to have Davison's first corner kick of the day. And I believe that is Snyder going to tee it up. Got the sun right there. Shooting right into the sun. You can see it on the camera.
High. Not close enough, though.
Yep. All right, and Heritage clears it out. And here they come. Good job keeping it in there. We'll have a Heritage throw now. 5:13 left in the half. 0-0 score. Got a handball there, so Davidson will have a kick. Crawford takes it. Nice boot. But it sails out of bounds. And possession goes back to Heritage.
Throwing now for Heritage. Gets around the defense, but can't center it.
Oh, I think he was trying to go to the net with that one, but he kind of shanked it off the side of his foot. Here comes the Cooley. Next whistle, it'll be Johnson coming in for DeCooley.
Oh!
Kuzno comes out.
Lucky there.
Yeah, lucky Crawford was there to knock that one away. Oh, another Heritage player down. Down by the Davison goal.
This is a penalty box there.
Yeah, he's holding his knee. We'll see how it turns out. Clock is stopped now with 3:25 left. As you see, Stacy, the Davison trainer, heading out to check on the injured Heritage player.
So both sides now are taking a bit of a break.
Yeah, it's like the halftime before the halftime.
Yep.
Checking her out there. So tell us some more about Australia. What don't we know about Australia we should know?
Oh, well, I don't know. We've got a lot of animals that some people haven't even heard about.
Well, tell us a couple.
Oh, well, we got wombats and frilled-neck lizards and all sorts of crazy little things.
Now, you guys have kangaroos all over down there, or what?
Yeah, you see kangaroos everywhere.
Are they kind of like squirrels here, just everywhere?
Oh, not as common as squirrels, but...
Okay, all right.
Definitely, if you go out towards in the outback, I guess, you'll see them everywhere. If you go camping, mm-hmm. just see them running around the bush. Yeah.
Fair enough. Now, how big is Australia area-wise?
Well, it's roughly the same size as the U.S. mainland, I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
A bit smaller, but yeah. It's spread out a lot. There's cities on both coasts, and yeah.
See. You miss home yet?
Oh, at times, I guess, but not that much.
Okay. Heritage player is up, and it looks like number 6, Benjamin Gordon. So he's limping off there with the help of one of his coaches, but we'll see if he comes back in the game. This could be a big loss for Heritage. I can't tell. It looked like he was holding his knee earlier, so I don't know if it's a knee or his ankle, but he's putting pressure on it, so that's good. He's not being lifted the whole way. So he's putting pressure on it, and we'll see if he's able to come back. He got a nice round of applause from the crowd. And play is getting ready to resume now. 3:25 left in the first half.
And it'll be a Heritage ball to restart play. Almost ready now.
All right, it'll be Saginaw's ball about midfield.
Referee blows the whistle, so we're underway again. High ball.
Oh, nice shot into it.
Lucky save there.
He slipped and had to reach up with his left hand to keep that ball in control, but he did it. Oh, and here comes Saginaw player number 12. Tall kid just in for the first time.
Good defense, though.
And here comes Zach Johnson. Tries to keep it in bounds. A little slow on it. And the new player in for Heritage, like I said, is number 12. And that's McGilvery. Going to rethrow that one. Thought there was a... It was a ball that leaked onto the field on the other end. Clock running now with about 2 minutes left, first half. 0-0 score. Here comes Johnson, see if he can turn it around. Over to Smith. Smith sends it forward. And then we got to run for it. Here we go,
Davison. First to it, but can't control it.
Oh, nice save. Came out to get it. That was Noble there. I thought Noble was going to have a chance to turn that around and put a shot on goal, but beat by the defense. So he plays it outside. Nice play there. Nice play. Watch the offsides. I'm yelling out orders like a coach now.
Out very, very wide there, the goalie.
I'll tell you, that goalie likes to wander, doesn't he?
He does.
That could come back to haunt him at some point. He's getting out there.
So throw in now.
That's what happens when goalies get bored. They start running around like they're out there playing playing forward.
Hopefully a challenge for him here. No, Too high.
Yeah, Smith tees it up, and that's over the fence and to the woods. So that's probably out on M15. I'll have to harass him about that in class tomorrow. So we'll have a goal kick for Saginaw. It bounced off someone's roof. Kept rolling. That was against the wind, too. There's Byers.
Davison's starting to control it now. Oh, no, they've got it back there. Heritage sends it down wide.
Here comes LeBlanc. He's got time. Puts a move on him, but not a second move. Good clear by Crawford. Crawford's kind of taking over for McManaman down there, and that is the end of the first half. And both teams here, they're playing their guts out. But I would say Heritage with a little bit of an advantage this time.
Yeah, that's right. They've certainly used a lot of pace early on and have created more opportunities.
All right, so we will join you for the second half in just a moment. But for right now, Saginaw Heritage and Davison tied at zero, and the second half is coming up.
Bridge of the boys' varsity soccer game between Davison, the Davison Cardinals, and
Saginaw Heritage Hawks.
Yep.
From the Saginaw Valley Conference. I used to play in the Saginaw Valley Conference back in the day.
Yeah.
Here's another back in the day story for the Flint Central Indians. Saginaw Heritage came here last year, and we went there, I believe, and we lost that game. But this game, we got 0-0, second half. You know, what are we going to see this half, you think?
Well, hopefully we can see a bit more attacking coming from Davison, and been some less offsides would be nice.
Yeah,
create some more opportunities.
Coach assured us that it's going to look better this half on the offsides. And we have the win this half, too, so that's going to help us with some of the balls.
So just Heritage controlling the ball down back to start us off. And attacking now. Oh, an opportunity, but.
Oh, that one was real close. I think they say even is off is the saying, and that one was splitting hairs, I tell you.
Unlucky
hairs.
Again.
Mm-hmm. All right, we're in the first minute here.
Long ball there, coming from Heritage. Both sides getting ahead on it. Now that guy just came out of nowhere now, looking to score, but can't get past the defense.
All right, we're going to have a kick here for Saginaw. McManaman set the check back in. His 10 minutes are up after the yellow card. So we got the wall there. Only a three-man wall, coach is yelling. And shifting them over a little bit. They do a little dipsy-do.
Low-lying ball there, but it's too much on the end of that one.
Up and over and out of play. And McManaman does check back in.
Substitution for the Cardinals, number eight, Nate McManaman.
Coming in, McManaman comes in for Casey Smith. Did a fine job while he was out there. McManaman will take this kick. Kuzno's only had to really make one save today that I remember. Two good saves, actually. He made two good ones. Crawford heads it.
Crawford again now.
Controls it. Taking his time.
Ooh. Going backwards, a little risky move there, and it's sent straight out.
He got lucky. McManaman got to that one. And we got a Davison throw.
Two-on-one there, gets the header, but not much beyond that, although it's gone out of bounds, so we'll get it back.
And Snyder will take the throw. Snyder had a scoring chance late in the first half on a runner, but he just missed off the corner kick. or just after the cross, actually, it was by DeCooley. Oh.
Throwing down the line, ineffective.
All right. A little indecision there. He didn't know if he wanted to play it or wait for it to go out. Snyder will throw it for the third consecutive time. Let's see if we get anywhere this time.
Looks like he's going to take it long this time.
Oh, over Crawford's head. Got a little bunch of players there. There you go. Get it back outside.
Nice. Out of bounds again.
Nice play by the defender there. Oh, got to put a bigger foot on it than that. White throw again. Snyder throws it again, working Kuba down the line. And finally cleared out by Heritage, and here comes LeBlanc, full head of steam. Fancy footwork there.
Nice little chip in there, trying to create something. Struggled to get around the Davison defense there.
Snyder, don't get caught watching the ball. All right, McManaman's going to take this kick again. Sends it right in the middle. Nice play there. Keeps it alive for Davison. Kuba's got a run here. Oh, struggles to keep it in, but it'll be a Saginaw throw. Here comes Snyder. Snyder, oh.
Good control there and ended up winning in the throw in there.
So 34 minutes now left in the game. Still no score. It wouldn't surprise me at all if this one ends up just like that. No score.
A bit of run now for Davison.
See if the cool can get it back outside. There it is.
Oh.
And here comes the wandering goalie.
Oh. What will happen here?
Still alive. It is!
Got it.
Off the pole. Snyder.
Goalie's still down.
Wow. Yeah, there was a collision there, definitely. But Snyder stayed on his feet, put the shot on the net, and it bounced off the pole. And the goalie is shaking up there for Heritage. What's the name of that goalie? Steven Sugg. Well, Sugg is definitely feeling it. And I can't tell if he caught a foot or what. I wish we had a replay here, but we don't, unfortunately. So he's down.
Yeah, he looks to be in a lot of pain there.
Mm-hmm.
So the game has been stopped temporarily. Not looking good for him.
They're definitely taking a look at him. I know the trainer, Stacy, went over to the football players, taping up the football players, but she'll be back soon, I'm sure. All right, so Stacy is on her way. Boy, looking back at that goal, that was a good move there for Snyder to stay on his feet and play that ball towards the net. Hits it off the far post, and it bounces in. And now Davison is up 1-0. That is goalie Steven Sugg.
He did did mention earlier that him wandering outside of the box like that could come back to haunt him. I didn't think you meant so dramatically.
I didn't think it would be an injury, but I thought maybe, you know, coming out that far, you're always more more apt to give up a goal that way. You know, if you don't win that ball or if you don't control that ball, that net is wide open, and that's what we got this time. Situation where, you know, it's sad to see him hurt, but you know at the same time he's 25 yards outside the goal area there, so he really made a run out, and the players are carrying him off to the side. And now their backup goalie, I'm not sure who they just put in there. It's hard to tell because the goalies don't have numbers. But that looks like Benjamin Gordon, who had played out in the field earlier. But don't quote me on that. We'll see if we can find out who it is. Can you tell what the goalie was holding? Was it a knee? Could you tell? Was it his leg? Okay. Mm-hmm. So 34-10 left in the first half, and Davison gets on the board first under crazy circumstances, but the goal does count. Okay, well, we're going to take a little break here until play gets underway. Okay, we are back now. McDowell. I thought that was Snyder on the goal. It was McDowell. Anyways, we're back in action here. And the new goalkeeper for Saginaw is Wesley Schrott. Wesley Schrott there coming in for goal. Now, it was a good news, bad news situation. We had Davison, of course, scoring the good goal, but Heritage's goalkeeper is still down over there on the sideline with Stacy, and they're tending to his leg. So actually, it was a double bad for Heritage there. So 33 minutes left, and Davison now in the lead, in control of this game, 1-0. And that may be all it takes to win this one. There's the blank. He likes that footwork. He likes the razzle-dazzle.
Davison with another chance to attack here.
Mm-hmm. All right. And I may have said that was Snyder on the goal, but obviously that was McDowell. Got too excited there. And now Sayers does come in for McDowell, giving him a breather. And normally we would have Sam Weber out there, but he's a little dinged up and not playing today.
Opportunity tries to go for the volley.
He tried the Pele move there, didn't he?
Yes.
Tried to whip his whole body around to get a foot on it, but totally whiffed. DTV has a busy week this week. We got the soccer game on Monday, and of course Tuesday there'll be volleyball action after the replay of this game. We'll have the live volleyball game. And then, of course, the football game on Friday will be live again from Cardinal Stadium after a week off. The Cards are back home.
High ball now. Goalie gets on the end of it.
You hear a big cheer for Wesley. He's a crowd favorite over there for Saginaw.
He's a cult figure.
There goes McManaman. Nice play, McManaman. Kicks it out, though. Down to the far corner. Nice defensive play. Oh, it's going to be Saginaw's ball, though. That was Marengo over there with the takeaway. And the defense clears it out again.
Heritage take it defensively now, and it's going to cost them. Yep. Davison win back the ball.
Oh, nice play. Play to get it back. Don't be offsides. Ooh. Kula's got to get back. Kuba was offsides, but McManaman's got to win this one. Goes and gets it. Caught. 30 minutes now, 30 minutes left in the game.
Good passing by Heritage. Trying to find some space. Chance now, but no.
Stay with them, Ben.
Davison win it back now. Got a bit of run on them.
Mm-hmm. And that's Snyder there.
Again, taking it defensively, Heritage.
Ooh,
gets around, though.
Nice foot. Gets a shot off. Ooh. Over Cousineau. Woo!
Good attempt there.
Yeah, it was LeBlanc. He really teed off on that one.
For the Cardinals, number 20, Eric Treanor.
I don't know if it's in Davison's best interest to go to a defensive mode now. I would keep attacking, especially with a backup goalie.
Yeah, that's absolutely right.
Mm-hmm.
No one to get that one, and it rolls out of bounds.
And if you're watching this on the replay, Thursday's night is senior night here at the last home game for the Davison Cardinals against Swartz Creek. That's a 4:30 start here, so if you haven't came out to a game yet, it's time to get out here, especially for seniors night.
Ooh. Ooh, goalie again coming out.
Yeah, they got aggressive goalkeepers here.
And we're going to see a corner kick here now for Davison.
Kay. Let's see how they work this one. And it looks like Mulholland is going to kick this one here from the corner. 28:47 left. Nice shot.
Direct
front of
there.
The net. Oh,
no one can find the header, though.
That was played nicely, though. I think that was a good spot for it to be. Goes McManaman, good pass in there.
Good attacking there now from Heritage, but no one on the end of the cross. Mm-hmm. Taking it wide.
Sun's starting to set a little bit now, so. Oh, here's a full head of steam. Kuba's got to get back.
And
now offsides.
Gets on the end of it. No.
Offsides. Yeah. Yeah, I could see that coming a mile away. He tried to get ahead of the play. So once again, he's called for the offsides. But he was. He was he was at least a foot or two ahead. So Coach Appleby not agreeing with the call, but I think he was from this angle. 27:40 now left.
Heritage taking it down the wing there.
And we got a foot race in the corner. Oh, a little rough play, no call. Getting physical down there. McManaman with the clear. That's what I'm talking about. So did you keep up with the American girls soccer controversy a couple weeks ago there?
No, I haven't heard about that one yet.
Yeah, that made a lot of Sports Center. The girls soccer, you know, doesn't usually make Sports Center, but they pulled their goalkeeper who had won 52 straight games.
Yes, I did hear about
that,
actually.
Yeah, and then they lost the next game 4-0. So that was a bit of a controversy. That team was supposed to make some noise in this year's World Cup. But
it's not a great idea to pull a goalie in the middle of a tournament in particular.
Yeah.
Australia made that mistake at the World Cup last year as well.
Oh, they did, huh?
Yep, but luckily we got a late goal and it got us through.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, I mean, if things are going deeper.
Mm-hmm.
Nope. McManaman played it to the center. Not a good play there.
Mm.
Oh, he gets lucky. He gets lucky. Shot goes wide. I suppose soccer's a lot like basketball. You don't want to throw the ball in front of your own net. You want to get it cleared out to the sides.
McManaman again kicking it in.
1-0 Davison on the McDowell goal. At about 3 minutes into the second half. Nice speed there. And that is Trainer, who's back in the game now.
Come on, guys, mark up in there.
Oh. Nearly a communication blunder there.
Yes. McDowell and Noble set the check back in. Looks like we got a kick.
Hey, we got three over here, four. Let's go, Kevin.
Coach Al will be telling them to mark up. Saginaw's got everybody in there now. They're trying to get a goal here.
No one on the end of it but Davison.
Play. Hey. Yeah, Heritage throw again.
Kevin, don't get sucked up so far.
Taking it forward again now.
That's the blank. He's dangerous. You got to watch him. Played out to Mulholland. Sends it nicely up the side. Now we got a foot race. And it looks like he'll play it back.
Oh, yep.
Call there, handball. Whoa. Oh. nobody happy with that call. The fans are giving it to the ref over there.
This certainly isn't his job, though.
Oh, there's a body. There you go. That's gonna be a Davison kick.
Stop.
24 minutes now left in the game. Davison up 1-0 versus Saginaw Heritage here.
Gonna send it along here. Header on that one. And then no one looking to score, though.
Nice job by Zach Hall to follow that one. He was all over that ball. That's how we do it here at DTV.
So the goal scorer coming back onto the field, McDowell.
All right. And DeCooley takes a break, gets a seat. And a great shot there. Following that ball the whole way.
McDowell with a nice touch there, and he's going to get back onto it. No. Oh. Goalie comes out.
Way out again. That was probably his best play on that one, though.
Mm.
The Davison player would have got there before he did if he would have waited back.
Davison with the numbers back there.
Oh, McMahon, way to turn it around.
One-on-one contest here.
Nice play.
Oh, back and forth there.
Ron, fight through that, please, okay? Don't be asking for a ball. Fight through it. Let's go.
Here goes Noble. Tries to win the head ball.
Heritage with the throw.
All right, 22 minutes now left in the game. Davison up 1-0 on a second half goal by Trevor McDowell.
In the game for the Cardinals, number 3, Aaron Snyder.
Ball comes back in and straight out again. Davison throw down the line.
Here comes McDowell again. Nice play by the Saginaw Heritage defender. That's number 19, Warner. And a great play on that. Watch behind him. Had a man on him.
Good hustle, 9. Your way, Bay.
Heritage, got the ball there. Passes to no one, though.
Man, kicks it out of play. And the Heritage team will set up again. It seems like Davidson is kind of sagging back and not pressing as much as they were at the beginning of this half. So I think they're content to stay with this one goal lead and see where it takes them.
Direct center there, but goes past the middle of the ground there. High ball down the field. No one on the end of it for Heritage.
Nice
another
shot.
Long one. Oh, dangerous that was.
Yeah. But it does go just a bit wide. Kuzma didn't even have to touch it. But they are getting closer now. And we are 20 minutes away from holding on to this victory. You think we can do it, Mike?
Yeah, I think with the pressure they're applying at the moment, win can't be that hard.
Yeah, but nothing really close or dangerous really this half for us, the Saginaw team. Oh, dangerous play. Going to call a high kick on that. So we'll get a kick going back the other way. Guy standing wide open. Why was that wide open? I don't know. Noble plays it outside, but back to Heritage. That sun is setting now in the west, so when you when we get our camera down there, that sun's going to interfere big time over there. I know. We don't. This is the only vantage point we really have from this field, so we're doing our best with that angle, and plus we get the pole in the way. Jeff, try to go around that pole if you can. There you go.
Heritage force very wide there. Now get a throw in.
Still pretty warm. It's cooled down a little bit, I think, since the start of the game, but not much. Kuzno with a leap there. I don't know that he needed to leap there, but he just wanted to show off his aerial skills. Thought he was playing basketball, going for a rebound or something. He's already about 6'4", as it is. Maybe 6'5". Oh, heads up. Nice catch.
Substitution at Broadway on the far sideline is Justin Mulholland.
Davis is now getting closer to the goals. It'll be a throw in.
Yeah, they're kind of inching it right down the line, aren't they? Who he was throwing to there. McDowell trying to win that one.
Yeah. Didn't want to give up.
Yep, here comes Crawford now. Crawford's got a full head of steam.
Oh, it takes on three of them.
Oh. Almost snuck it through there and had a shot on goal.
McDowell controls it.
Kicks it back out nicely. Ooh, nobody there on the other pass, though. He should have tried to send that all the way across, I think. He had the time. There we go.
Davison went it back, did
somebody
they?
Somebody watching. Yes, they did, but then they had a couple people watching. And that's a Davison throw. We got a handball.
Several handball calls during the game today.
All right, what do we got here? We got a kick or do we got a throw? We got some kind of discussion here. Looks like it's going to be a Davison kick. A little push in the back by the Saginaw. Oh, going to be a Davison throw. They can't make up their mind. I can't make up my mind. Nobody can make up their mind. There it was. Nice play by Kuba.
No one in the center of the field, though. So Davison chasing after it now. Nice little back hill there. Sets up a bit of a run now. Gets past the defender. It'll be throwing. A lot of momentum now.
See if they can turn this into something.
Need to find
somebody's
the center and goal, though.
Yeah, there he goes. Needs a little help there. Somebody's got to push up and help him. Tries to cross it, but it's blocked. Oh, what do we got here? little bumping, too much bumping down here? Or did it go out of bounds? All right, 15 and a half now left in the game. Davison up 1-0. Trying to hold on to this lead. First half ended 0-0. Trevor McDowell, the goal scorer for Davison.
Oh,
sends it out.
Tries to keep it in.
And it does, but it'll eventually roll out. Heritage coming with a host of substitutions.
Davison are really controlling the play now.
All right, now we got a foot race. That's number two, just came in the game for Davison. It's Quinn, but he will lose it. Crawford, yep, big kick.
Right to Kev. He can't handle you, Kev.
McManaman's going to tee this one up. He's going to take his time, though.
Sends it long.
And that's Quinn there on the header. Kuba's going to get a shot. Kind of whiffed on it a little bit. Didn't get his whole foot on that. Schropp made the save. And rolls it out.
Pressure now. Oh, here we go. Opportunity.
This is Schneider now.
Oh, can't keep up with the ball, though. Spent it before he had it there.
Yes, he did.
Lots of high balls on this play. Finally, it's down on the ground. Heritage looking to attack, but there aren't that many men open.
No, there's a lot of white down there in front of him. He didn't have anywhere to go with that. Nice footwork there. Davison's
Heritage controlling the ball. Well,
oh,
he'll go for the shot, but wide.
Yeah, he had the Beckham bend there.
Yep.
He didn't need it. So now we've got about 12 and a half now left in the game. Davison's still holding on to the one goal lead.
Davison went out in the middle there. Looking to get a good run. McDowell trying to get on the end of it.
Uh-huh. Still there, he's still there.
One on one with the defender, but it's cleared. We'll have a Davison throw in now.
Uh-huh. 12 minutes now. Marengo with the throw to DeCooley.
Controls it well.
McDowell, oh. You hit that a little bit harder to McDowell, would have got that through. Here we go again. Sun now starting to go down. Maybe it'll be out of play by the time this game ends.
That kick went a little wide.
Yeah, you can still see the sun there in our shot when we face west, but not as in the middle of the field as it used to be. Now here comes Marengo again. He's going to fling it up there. A little too long. Got to put the pressure on him. Oh, nice job. Here comes McDowell now. All right, got about 11 now, 11 minutes left.
It's 2-on-1, and it's forced out now, so it'll be a Davison ball.
Heritage really hasn't had any good looks this half.
I think, that goal there from McNeil was really the turning point in the game. Yeah. Heritage haven't looked like a chance since then.
Yeah, it kind of took the wind out of their sails, huh?
Mm. down the field here, but Heritage will go back to their goalie. And he'll kick it downfield.
Got a bunch of clowns behind us right now. I don't know what they're laughing at. I think the crowd's gotten bigger since the game started. Appears to be that way. So we're going to have a Heritage kick here from midfield. Sends it right in the middle of the box. Nice play there. That's number 7, Nitzke. Nitzke also a basketball player. Oh, handball, yep. There we go.
Another handball call.
Under 10 now left in this this game. Second half has been all Davison. Scoring a goal early in the second half. McManaman with a boot. That thing almost cleared the whole field. Oh, got to stand. No, just standing around.
Wild shot of that one.
Davison almost took advantage of some lazy defender play there.
Heritage trying to bring it down the field, but Davison just too strong in defending at the moment.
Just going to win there. Davison wins the ball down in the corner. Oh, but it's over to Saginaw. And we got some. Oh, thought they were going to have a sub, but didn't happen. Good left there.
Fancy flick there. They ended up winning out there, Davison.
I send it. Oh, get onside. Get onside. He waits. Nice job. Wait till he get onside. Oh, I got to send that, though.
Kevin, take it yourself next time. Baby.
Substitution for the Hawks, number 16, Matthew Lopez. And substitution for the Cardinals, number 4, Ron Noble.
Cooley will sit down. 8 minutes left.
Takes on a pack of three, gets through them quite easily. An interesting pass there. Can he get on the end of it?
Ooh.
Massive clearance there.
Yeah. All right, so here we go. Here's the throw. And it'll be a goal kick there for Heritage. Only goal of the day coming from Trevor McDowell. Early in the second half. Davison up 1-0. Hoping to hold on for the victory here against the Heritage Hawks. Oh, a little push in the back. Yeah, they're going to call that. They're going to call that. Yeah, Noble knew it too. As soon as he put those hands on him in the back, he was going to get called for that. That's Blake. Oh,
out of nowhere with that one.
All right, Davison can't get sloppy here. This is the wrong time to get sloppy. Let's go. We have a Davison throw here. Marengo will take it. He's going to try to send it up.
Oh,
nobody there, though. Here comes McDowell.
McDowell trying to get the pass on there, but no one could get on the end of it.
So Heritage here, almost time to desperation for desperation here. Got about 6 minutes left in the game. So we should see their intensity start to pick up here as the seconds close in on them.
Nice Nice touch there, but McDowell can't get around the last defender. And Heritage regain the ball.
Comes Noble. It's Crawford taking control out there. Over to Noble. And Davison's really trying to win these balls here. Well, that's a good sign.
Sends it down the line, but header was ineffective.
Noble drops it right back in there. McDowell's going to have a corner kick here, it looks like. So we'll see if he can turn this one. Put it in. 5 minutes now left. Davis not putting everybody up there.
Opportunity to double their lead now here, Davison.
We'll see where he plays it. He's really not in a hurry to kick this either.
Just winding down the clock.
There it is. Sends it long.
No one can really get on the end of it, though.
You see him practice all the, you know, the different plays and in practice, and it's a lot harder when you sprinkle in a bunch of defenders in there. You know.
Heritage going forward on the counterattack now, but struggling there down the wing.
Nice play, Mulholland. Oh, it goes out of bounds on him. Oh, here we go. A lot of people checking in. We got number two, Quinn, for Davison, along with DeCooley, and about four or five Heritage players jump in there.
Number 12, Eric Hard.
Clock ticking now with 4 minutes left. Davison up 1-0, trying to hold on for victory.
Eric Conley. Number 23, Jeffrey Marushimano.
Ben, who are you marking?
And number 8, Don Evans, EJ Evans.
Aye. The Heritage have the throw in here. Can't make much of the opportunity, though.
3:30 now left in the game.
Another chance for him. Find the header. Another
here. Oh, I thought he
nearly went for a big strike there. He's got it back though.
Uh-oh, somebody's got to step up here.
A chance for him. Oh, some great defending there. They forced that one out.
Yeah, I thought he was going to tee that up, but he kind of misfired on it. That would have been interesting because that kid's got a big foot from out there. All right, Davison hoping to hold on here. McManaman's going to kick this one as far as he can, I'm sure. Make him chase it for a while. There it goes. Well over midfield. Cooley kicks it out. Heritage resets. Here they come. Nice play. Head in the corner.
Looking to center it now.
And still battling down the right corner.
There we go. Davison get it back.
Nice work.
Some good pressure there in the defense.
That's Quinn.
Now they've got an opportunity.
And here comes Kuba.
Goalkeeper doesn't come out for this one. It's a one-on-one race.
Kuba trying to turn it back around, and he does. Here comes Quinn. Oh, taken away from Saginaw. And here we go, 2 minutes now, 2 minutes left in this game. Here comes Quinn, nice job.
There
I'd just send this one. I'd send him and make him think about it. Oh, give it right back. Oh, that could have been a good give and go right there. All right, Davison's still holding in there. Saginaw's probably their last blast coming up. Kuzno's going to come out and get that. Nice play. 1:30 now. 1:30 left in the game. There it goes. Heritage looking to get something here.
Davison just keep maintaining that pressure. The deeper they go down the field, the harder it is for them to find a man.
Holland's going to clear it out. Here comes Crawford.
Trying to get into some space. And
Crawford's
going to
speed
him. He's got a lot of speed, but.
Nice play by the defender.
Leaves out in the end, and he'll kick it straight out.
I liked how Crawford tried to challenge him there, though. He He said, I'm going to use your speed against mine. We're going to see who wins. Under a minute now. Under a minute left in this game. Davison up 1-0, trying to hold on.
Davison should just run down the clock from here. You can see he's got a long run up there.
Oh, the flip
throw. Going off.
Yeah, the flip throw. I'm going to do those after the game here. Just the flip throw. Should have figured that was coming. 23 seconds, and this could do it. All right. Oh, here he comes with
do
the flip thing. He's lining up from the pure road running in and flipping. Oh, he didn't do it. He didn't do it. 4 seconds.
That's it.
And that's going to do it. Davison holds on to win against Saginaw Heritage 1-0. And that is our game. What are your final thoughts here?
Well, it was always tight, and both sides tried to attack, but both defenses were pretty good. Trevor McDowell got into some space and scored a great goal.
Yeah, I think what happened was the Saginaw goalkeeper kept coming out, and finally he got beat on one. So there it goes. Your typical soccer game, 1-0, ends in good Davison fashion with the victory. Don't forget to come out Thursday for the game against Swartz Creek, and we will see you on other DTV events. Mike, thanks for having you.
Yeah,
good
no
work
problem.
Today. Good work today.
Thank you very much.
It's our Australian exchange student bringing us home today. All right. For DTV, good night.